Hello, the wait is over. Today is Mutton Bowl Sunday. We have two teams, the Patriots and the Vikings. They are warming up on their respective sides of the field right now. One team, the winner, will take home the Bad Tunes Mutton Bowl trophy. This trophy. Handed out two of these before. One to the Bengals, and then one to the Jets. And they have a banner right here underneath the SFL logo. Bengals, Jets. Right here, we'll be adding either the Patriots or the Vikings. Okay. Let's see what our villagers have to say about this. Now we have three pandas that would like to share with you their predictions to the game. And we have a Vikings guy that isn't really happy with that. Or not? One of the guys picked you. The middle guy? Yeah. Let's show them they're wrong. And win. The Vikings have been training hard. Their NFL affiliate has never won the Super Bowl. They are looking to change that. At least for the SFL. The Patriots are looking to take home another ring. It'll be the seventh banner. But that was the NFL. Neither of these teams have ever won the Mutton Bowl, as this is only the third Mutton Bowl. Pandas, why don't you get in the stands? Yes, you have tickets to the game. You'll get to watch it. Yes, you do. Okay, there. Do whatever you want in the stands. Just don't fall on the field. Especially you, who is standing right on the wall. You can go down and run around in there, or sit in the stands. We have our dog, who's a huge SFL fan, watching from over here. This dog became an SFL fan by being a wolf and interfering with a preseason game and killing all the sheep on the field. And that gave the dog SFL season tickets. And now it is here at the Mutton Bowl, ready to cheer on both teams. We have a bunch of pigs over here, rooting for the Vikings. They have a nice little setup, tailgating. While we have a bunch of cows over here, tailgating and rooting for the Patriots to win. They both have great setups, but the problem is, when people were driving their cars in, we had a bit of an accident. They crashed. Two cars of enemy teams crashed. These people do not like each other. They will not both be the champions. Now the Vikings made their way back to their locker room to give themselves some final preparations for the big game. It's going to be a tough matchup. And it looks like the Patriots have done the same. They're in their locker room, getting ready for the game. They're all crammed up in one corner for some reason. It's gonna be a tough game for both teams. The field is now empty. This is the calm before the storm. Four quarters, 6 minutes each. These fields will be filled with players competing for the Bad Tunes Mutton Bowl trophy. Everything is on the line tonight. One team. Just one. Now, I think the players are ready to take the field. taking the field first. The Minnesota Vikings. Rain starts pouring. Won't stop anybody on this field. Present to you, Minneapolis, Minnesota. Minnesota Vikings. Now from Foxborough, Massachusetts. Present to you the New England Patriots. To play in Mutton Bowl 3. Two teams out on the field. Now, for those who are able, we ask you to please rise and remove your caps for the playing of America's national anthem.
Congratulations to both teams on how far you've made it. You've come far. Now we will do the coin toss to determine who spawns first. Winner of the coin toss will get to decide if they will spawn first to start the game or spawn first to start the second half. We'll play four quarters. Whoever spawns first for the first quarter, the other team will spawn first for the second quarter. The team spawns first for the second quarter will spawn first for the third quarter. And the team that spawns first for the first quarter will also spawn first for the fourth quarter. That was a little bit of a tongue twister, but let's do the coin toss. One side of this coin is green, it's a special Lego coin. The other side of the coin is black, it's the colors we had. The black side will represent the Patriots. The green side will represent the Vikings. Let's flip the coin. Where did it land? On the ground. It landed on green. The Vikings have won the toss. And the Vikings select to defer. So, the Patriots, which side would you like to spawn on? Okay, the Patriots would like to spawn on the left side. Okay. There you have it. Get ready for the game.
Okay, the rain just stopped. Let's explain the rules first, then we'll get the game started. So, since the Patriots have got to spawn first because of the coin toss, and they picked to spawn on the side first, so 11 players on the Patriots will spawn on the 30-yard line. And 11 players on the Vikings will spawn on this 30-yard line for the first quarter. For the second quarter, 3 players on the not three. 11 players on the Vikings will spawn first on this Thursday. Then 11 players on the Patriots will spawn second on this Thursday. Then to start the second half, we'll have Vikings spawn first on this Thursday, Patriots on this Thursday. And then start the fourth quarter, it'll be Patriots spawn on this Thursday, then Vikings spawn on this Thursday. And scoring, you get 7 points if you cross the goal line in the big end zone. For a field goal, you have to be inside the 10-yard line at the end of a quarter, and then that's 3 points. There will be 4 6-minute quarters. We'll have an official game clock on the screen at the top. Let's spawn the players. Clock will start as soon as we finish spawning them. The New England Patriots. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This is sad. A lot of them. Is that all of them? Yeah. Okay, now. The Minnesota Vikings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So the last one gets its uniform. Clock starts. Okay. Clock started. Okay, let the Mutton Ball begin. Here at John Madden Stadium. Okay, Patriots, looking to do something. Vikings, moving around as well. Oh. Yes, first and 10 at the 20-yard line. Throws it down the midfield. Oh, oh. Does he catch it? He does. But will he make a run after the catch? Oh, he's running. A lot of defense. Like 23 yards in front of him. Okay. One team will take home the Badtoons Mutton Bowl trophy. Everything is on the line. Oh, Vikings. He's moving. We got one guy in field goal range already. And he leaves field goal range. He goes back in. Oh, maybe looking for a touchdown. Oh, he's that close. Oh, at the 2-yard line. Two yards away from the first touchdown of the Mutton Bowl. When he runs away. Could have scored the first touchdown of the Mutton Bowl. But he passed the opportunity. Oh, he's thinking about it again. Oh, oh. Oh, touchdown, Vikings! He leaves the end zone. Vikings get the first touchdown of the Mutton Bowl. They take a 7-0 lead. Patriots may be looking to do something to respond to that. And they don't really seem to be moving. Now they're moving. They're already down 7-0. It is 7-0 Vikings. Maybe wants to go and score again. He very well could. Maybe Patriots want to at least enter field goal range before the end of the quarter. Oh, is it going to happen? Touchdown, Vikings! The Vikings go up 14-0 to start the game. With about 3 minutes left of the quarter, will he get all his legs out of the end zone? He does. Okay, already 14-0 Vikings with three guys in field goal range. Been high scoring so far, but only for one team. Remember, last year's Mutton Bowl It was between the Jets and the Saints. Went into overtime. Then the Jets came away with that one. But it really came down to the last wire. Okay, Patriots, desperate to do something. The game just started. But they're not off to a good start, that's for sure. But it is a four-quarter game. Just because you do good in the first quarter doesn't mean there isn't still three other quarters to play. But so far, the Vikings do have momentum. It is 14-0. And if the quarter was to end now, it would be, touchdown, Vikings! Okay, it's 21-0. And if the quarter was to end now, it would be 27-0. Okay, it's 21-0 Vikings, and it is only the first quarter. So far, it's been a blowout. 21-0. We have one guy in field goal range now. Will he make it a 28-0 game? He very well might. Still has another minute to do it, a little more than that. Another guy enters field goal range, maybe looking to score. All the action has been on this side of the field. Patriots, are you gonna do something? This guy does not seem to want to play. Hey, your team needs to. It's a Mutton ball. Okay, 18, 17, 16, 15. Okay, quarter is running out. Counting the guys in field goal range so we can determine field goals. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. End of first quarter. We have two guys in field goal range. So that makes it 27-0 Vikings after one. Okay, let's get you to the next quarter. Hello, before we start the second quarter, taking you to the Nether for a little mini game. This will be is we'll have a piglet go out and explode either the 49ers on the right or the Chiefs on the left. The piglet will decide which one of the plates it wants to step on and pick the winner for the actual Super Bowl later today. So let's spawn him and see which one he predicts. Just remember, this one is Chiefs, this one is 49ers. Whichever one he explodes is the one he's predicting to lose. Okay, step on a pressure plate. Which one will he step on? And he steps on that one, exploding the Chiefs, predicting the San Francisco 49ers to win the Super Bowl later tonight. Okay, that's prediction. So now let's get you to the second quarter. Okay, now we'll start the second quarter. Vikings will spawn first on this side, and the Patriots will spawn after that. Clock starts as soon as everyone gets their uniform. Okay, here are the Minnesota Vikings. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Taking on the New England Patriots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. clock is about to start. There was a mistake. Okay, it started. Here's the Butterball. Quarter two. Vikings already up 27-0. As one guy goes out of bounds and he's looking right into the Patriots tunnel. Hey, all their players are out on the field, not in the locker room. He looks like he was gonna go into the tunnel, but then he goes just to the right of it. Okay, let's keep playing. Vikings looking to add to their lead. Patriots looking to do something to come back. It's not like they've done something like that in Super Bowl before. So we have one guy on the wrong team's bench. You don't need to be on the bench, you can be on the field. Is this guy still out of bounds, just watching his team play with an obstructed view of the field? Pandas in the crowd aren't even looking at the game. Okay. Patriots maybe want to do something. They're moving a lot more than the Vikings are this quarter. This guy's moving. Crosses the 40. Who's going? Oh, he stopped. He's going again. Okay, it looks like they're both just as close to scoring right now. Vikings, a little closer. Oh, he's moving. Okay, it's 27-0 Vikings. With 3:40 left of the first quarter. The second quarter, sorry. My mistake. Yeah. We have 3:28. 4:23. Still no one in field goal range. The first quarter was a lot more high scoring. We will have a halftime show for you. You'll find out what it is at halftime. But you don't get to see the halftime show until halftime, because it's a halftime show, not a middle of the second quarter show. But stay tuned for that, because you don't want to miss it. It's better than seeing Usher in the Super Bowl. You want to see the Mutton Bowl halftime show. Trust me. But we do know the Piglin did predict the 49ers to win the Super Bowl tonight, but we don't know if the Piglin is going to be right or not, but there's one way to find out. It's to watch Moneyball, watch Moneyball now, then watch the Super Bowl later tonight. Okay, you're at, 16 right now. And he walks away. Well, I thought all quarters would be that high scoring. Patriots, are you gonna do something? You kind of have to right now. He crosses midfield. We have just over a minute and a half left of the first half. And the Patriots haven't scored anything. The Vikings... Sorry for that. I'm dying. The Vikings have scored 27 points in the first quarter, but still nothing in the second. Did the first quarter tire them out? That's irrelevant. What is relevant is Mr. Irrelevant from the draft tonight. And we still have two more quarters to play after this. Under a minute left of the second quarter. Still no one anywhere close to scoring right now. Maybe you could go across the 10 and maybe get a field goal. Maybe one of you could do it. Okay, under 30 seconds left. I don't think there is going to be any scoring in the second quarter. But you never know. Still need to play the rest of the second quarter. Clock is gonna expire soon. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And that's all for the second quarter. Seemed really quick. And no one scored. That's weird. First quarter, 27-0, 0-0. Second quarter. Okay, let's take you to halftime. Okay, now for the halftime show, we will be doing a little miniature tournament between donkeys, cows, pigs, and chickens. We have two games going on at once to start. And then the winners of each of those two games will then play each other. We will have donkeys and cows on this field, and then pigs and chickens on this field. Rules are similar to basic SFL rules, except you can only score a touchdown and first to 14 will win the game. Still be 3-on-3. Let's spawn cows and donkeys first. The cows and donkeys. Now let's get the pigs and chickens out. Pigs and chickens. First to 14 wins. We'll be watching both games at once. We're multitasking here. One touchdown for the chickens. Chickens take a 7-0 lead. Okay, donkeys looking to score. They are really close. But in the chickens and pigs game, the chickens are up 7-0. But you need 14 points to win. So chickens can win with another touchdown. Cows are looking to score. Donkeys are just eating the grass. So nothing chickens, 0-0 for the cows and donkeys. In a multitasking tournament. And whichever game ends first is the field we will be doing the championship for the tournament on. No one is really moving. Donkeys thinking about it. He is one block away. Oh, touchdown donkeys as he touches the white line. Okay, 7-0 donkeys and 7-0 chickens. Either one of those teams could score another touchdown and win the game. Okay, does he fully leave the end zone? So we need to keep our eyes on both fields. Is he pushing his enemy into the end zone? He's thinking about scoring. And touchdown, Donkeys! As the Donkeys get the upset since they move slower and they win the game. So looks like this is the field we'll be doing the championship on, but now we can focus more on this game between the pigs and the chickens. Okay. Chickens are still up 7-0. Little pigs looking to tie it. One touchdown, pigs! Okay, next touchdown, we'll win the game. Well, that's another touchdown for the pigs. They get comeback and win the game. Okay, looks like we'll be having pigs and the donkeys in the mini animal tournament championship. Okay. Okay, it is time for the championship round of the halftime animal tournament. And we have the donkeys and the pigs. Loser goes away. The winner gets free tickets to the rest of the Mud Bowl here at Joy Bad Stadium. So here are the donkeys and the pigs. Donkeys looking to score early. It would be a huge upset if they win, because they are the slowest animal in the tournament, and the pigs are the fastest. Oh, the stocky looking to score. He's close. He's two blocks away. Pigs looking to score a touchdown. Oh, he doesn't. Oh. Touchdown, pigs. Okay, 7-0 pigs. Pigs can win with another touchdown, and that's exactly what they do. Pigs have to stay here and watch the rest of the game, and donkeys have to leave. Okay, see you for the third quarter. Hello, it is time to start the third quarter. Vikings have the lead, and they will spawn first. So here are the Minnesota Vikings. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Taking on the New England Patriots. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. As I set the clock, quarter will begin. Okay, on to the second half of the Mutton Bowl. It's been one-sided, but now the Patriots are really moving, trying to make a comeback. Vikings, looks like you're playing conservative, trying to protect your lead. And I understand that. Okay, but it's 27-0 Vikings. You never know what could happen. As of now, it looks like it's gonna be the Vikings. You never know. You have one guy on the Patriots right in front of the team's tunnel, and he goes into the tunnel. Okay, that's on you. We are just under a minute in to the third quarter. We have one guy who is kind of close to field goal range. No one really close to scoring for the Vikings right now. Okay, Patriots, they really need to do something. Vikings, if they really want to, they can't just hang out on the field. But the Patriots really can't do that. Are you still in the tunnel? You are. You're not helping your team at all. Oh, one guy enters field goal range. And the guy from the tunnel looks like he's about to enter field goal range. Oh, he does. Oh. Stop at the one. He might actually go right from the tunnel to the touchdown. Yes, he does. Touchdown, Patriots. It is now 27-7 with another guy in field goal range. Overthrew. A little less than 4 minutes left of the third quarter. And Patriots have 7. The Vikings have 27. Vikings are still up by 20. So that doesn't really hurt them much. Patriots are close to scoring. One guy's kind of close to scoring. Vikings have no one anywhere near scoring. Okay, not really much has happened since the touchdown, but at least we know we're not only going to have scoring in the first quarter. Patriots, are you going to do anything else to try to make a comeback? Looks like the Patriots guy leaves the end zone. He can go back in and score again if he wants. He just walks away from the end zone. Okay, it is 27-7. Vikings, as I've said a bunch of times, but now I said it again. No one that close to scoring right now. Except for this guy, which is close to field goal range. Vikings, are you going to do anything to maybe get some insurance points? Heading towards midfield, that's not going to help you. What are you doing here? You're not helping your team at all. You're probably helping your team the least out of everyone here. Especially if you go climb into the stands. That would be terrible for your team. You're lucky you have 10 other players. Okay, this guy is back in the tunnel. So is this guy. Okay, we do actually have one guy who's close to scoring. Okay, he's not doing anything. Well, not much is happening right now. Let's talk about the Super Bowl later tonight. Chiefs and the Vikings. Yes, I know nobody wanted those two teams in the Super Bowl, but they are both in the Super Bowl. And I don't know about you, but I'll still be watching it. I don't really want either teams to win it, but I would rather the 49ers win it. So go 49ers tonight. Okay, well, that ends the quarter. This guy is not in bounds, so that cannot count as a field goal. It is 27-7. Vikings, 6 minutes, will be crowning a champion. Two banners up now. One of them will be added tonight. Third banner, either the Vikings or the Patriots. We have fire lit all around the stadium to get ready for the fourth quarter. The Patriots will be spawning first on this side. So here are the New England Patriots. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Taking on the Minnesota Vikings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, let the fourth quarter begin as we look to soon crown a champion. But unfortunately, this is going to have to be the end of the SFL season. But the last quarter of SFL is still SFL. It's like the fire is starting to burn part of the carpet over the infield dirt for the baseball field. But that's okay, don't worry about it. As long as it doesn't get to the field, we'll keep playing. Okay, Patriots are desperate to do something. They are down by 20. Vikings just need to hold on to the lead for another like 5 minutes, and they will be presented the Bad Toons Mutton Bowl trophy. Okay, so Vikings, they're at the 20. And the Patriots have their closest guy to scoring at like the 19, maybe 18. He's going. He needs more than just a field goal. Oh, it goes out of bounds. Okay, Vikings, are they going to do something to add a cushion to their lead? Vikings are still up 27-20. And time is running out. Just over 4 minutes left of the Mutton Bowl. Patriots at the 8-yard line. And he goes out of bounds. He's heading right towards the fire. Don't cook yourself. If you cook yourself, you don't get to respawn. Yeah, we really have a fire starting. Whatever. Stadium burns down. It'll burn out in 4 minutes. We have 3.5 minutes left of the game. Okay. Vikings, are you gonna do something now? All eyes are on you. You look like you're going to be crowned a champion in 3 minutes. So you'll have to play the next 3 minutes and you'll win the Mutton Bowl. Okay. So like these players seem to at least some of them seem distracted by the fire. It never works when we try to light fire around the stadium. But we do it anyways, because it's cool. Okay. The Vikings went up by 27 in the first quarter, but then the third quarter, the Patriots managed to bring it down to being only down by 20 points. But still it wasn't enough, as we had just over 2 minutes left of the game. Patriots seem very desperate, although they're not doing much. They're getting ready to go home and watch the Super Bowl tonight, or maybe go watch the Puppy Bowl after this. I don't know. But they sure aren't playing very well. This has been all Vikings. This guy isn't really playing right now, but doesn't matter because I don't think Patriots are going to be able to do anything. But still have to play next minute and a half because anything can happen. Because the field is really burning down. But it really don't matter. Okay. Minute 10 to go. Oh. From the regular season game. These teams had to win. Kept winning in the playoffs. It all came down to this. Who could do the best on the full field? On 11-on-11. If under a minute. And then we'll be going to crown champion. 40 seconds. The Patriots seem to literally have just quit. No one's moving. Oh. This guy's moving now. Vikings are moving. Getting ready to celebrate. He trying to get a last hurrah. Oh no, he goes out of bounds. What do the Pandas think of this? Hey, 10 seconds left on the Mutton ball. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And the Minnesota Vikings are the Mutton ball champions. They win it. Let's put their banner up right now. They just won. Mutton ball. Vikings. To 2024. There, Mutton ball champions. Let's celebrate. The Vikings have officially won the Mutton Bowl. They're on the podium, as they'll now be awarded the Bad Toads Mutton Bowl trophy. Third one of these is awarded. What are you gonna do now? You just won the Mutton Bowl. You're gonna go to Disney World? Oh, really? That's awesome. You guys all worked hard for this. Played all four quarters. Or just the first quarter, but you really played in the first quarter that you didn't have to play in the other three. Now, who's ready for some Gatorade showers? First, take the meat of players on the other team that you beat. Yes. Those are your enemies, right there. Who wants some water? Gatorade or Waterade? Water shower. Here's your Gatorade shower. All over the trophy, you get your Gatorade shower. You get a full Gatorade shower experience. Mutton Bowl champions. Worked hard. You deserved it. Go dry off your trophy. And celebrate. Because you worked hard. Hoist the trophy. It's been a great SFL season. We're going to miss it. But sheep football, still, it's going to go on for a little bit longer. Because we have the off-season tournament coming up. This is going to be for all teams that did not make the playoffs, and it'll be a tournament to determine which one will be guaranteed a playoff spot next year. But until then, see you. Got a recap of the season, then a parade. It's been a great season. Good night, SFL.